You've got a friend in me. When the road looks rough ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed, you just remember what your old past said. Boy, you got a friend in me. Yeah, you got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got trouble, and I got them too. There isn't anything I wouldn't do for you. We stick together.
David Sherman. The handsome, successful young man you know and love. But beneath that charming persona is another, more complex individual. The David, who for years has been hidden from the public eye. Until now. In the next several minutes, we will examine the life of David Sherman. From his humble beginnings as a Pizza Hut manager's son, to his rise to the Renaissance man attorney he has become. This is the Stranger Than Fiction tale of a charismatic boy with a very strange past. This is David's story. The E! True Hollywood Story of David Michael Sherman. But that's how it goes. David Michael Sherman was born to Glenn and Karen Sherman on July 21st, 1985, in the small town of Macon, Georgia. Father Glenn was thrilled to have a son to carry on the family name. Mother Karen was thrilled to have a son so she could stop having children. And sisters Lisa and Lauren were thrilled to have a real-life baby doll to play with. It seemed the perfect life. But as with most families in South Georgia, it wasn't long before they got wrapped up in the world of toddlers, tiaras, and pageantry. The strange thing is, it was David who insisted on participating. Dainty Sunshine, as he was known around town, spent his days at photo shoots, searching for that perfect headshot. His nights were spent rehearsing his runway walk and poses. Bath time, and even the chicken pox, were no excuse to slack off on practice. Eventually, however, it became clear Dainty Sunshine wasn't really cut out for a career as a prima donna, and the other children started taunting her.
You better redneck a nice!
David began focusing on what else he could be when he grew up, and the flighty behaviors began, changing jobs every few months. A cowboy, an Indian, a BMX bike rider, an NBA basketball player, a baseball player, or maybe a tennis pro, a Boy Scout leader. By this point, David had quite a few years under his belt and a very exhaustive resume, but not much to show for it in his mind. His behavior had become stranger than ever, and his loved ones began to worry. David had discovered women, and he was desperate to figure out what he could do to attract them, which occasionally got him into some trouble. His attendance at the Backstreet Boys, NSYNC, Hanson, and 98 Degrees concerts made a light bulb go off, and he realized he needed to become a musician. But it only took a few football games for him to realize that being a member of the high school marching band wasn't making him the girl magnet he had hoped it would. And for some reason, switching to the guitar didn't work either. You won't hear this anywhere except on the E! True Hollywood Story, but David briefly entertained the idea of leaving women behind altogether. He started spending a lot of time with the boys. He even brought back some of his pageantry poses. And he started saying weird things like, "I guess the look I'm best known for is blue steel." His family didn't approve, but they still loved and supported him, despite his alternative lifestyle and cross-dressing tendencies. Fortunately, he quickly became aware this wasn't the right path for him, determining girls really smelled a lot better than boys. Things were looking up for a while, David made good grades, graduated from high school, and was accepted to Auburn University. In the summer of 2003, the family got together to send him off and wish him well. Little did they know of the dangers and temptations that awaited him there. David joined a fraternity, met a guy named Eric, and fell into a vicious cycle of drinking, gambling, and bizarre behavior. He began hanging out with people of questionable repute, or spent hours putting together puzzles by himself. And sometimes he could be found alone downtown, sitting on the ground, yelling obscenities at people walking by. He was aloof at family functions, preferring to play with his toys rather than talk to his relatives. And when he did interact, it was often rude or inappropriate.
Well, I guess I was wrong. I just don't belong. Then I've been
Despite his wild college career and questionable antics, he somehow managed to graduate. Unfortunately, during a particularly inebriated moment of fraternity graduation party, David made a mistake that will haunt him for the rest of his life. That's right. He kidnapped a child. Now, I know most of you think that David spent the year after college in Costa Rica teaching English. Ladies and gentlemen, E-True Hollywood Story is here to tell you David was actually incarcerated during that time. Luckily for him, his father is a very powerful attorney and was able to bargain for early release after only 6 months of good behavior. The judge's only stipulation, much to David's chagrin, was that he had to attend law school, learn the law, and spend the rest of his life practicing. Begrudgingly, David moved away from the dirty South to Chicago, Illinois, where he anticipated starting law school at DePaul University. This brings us to August 22nd, 2009, the first day of class, now forever known as M Day, as in the day David Sherman met Michelle Alameda. Now, Michelle was a beautiful, intelligent young lady who, fortunately for David, had a tender heart for lost souls and men who knew how to cook. She also appreciated a good sign and felt he would make an adequate study partner. David was enamored by her presence and vowed to do whatever he needed to win her affection, even if it meant showering every day. After 3 years of studying together and getting to know one another, Michelle's good influence had rubbed off and David had been rehabilitated. He was accomplishing things he had never done before, putting food on the table and completing marathons. As his time in school came to a close, he realized that if he had to spend the rest of his life practicing law, he had better have a good woman by his side. And on May 13, 2011, David proposed to Michelle. She said yes, and the news spread like wildfire. People came from near and far to offer David their congratulations.
Congratulations, David and Michelle. I thought he was gay. He wore a gay collar, and I'm so happy he's not. The best of luck to both of you.
Overall, the public was ecstatic. Meanwhile, David and Michelle graduated, moved to Atlanta, and began working. The pending nuptials have been a hot topic amongst the press. Rumor is the much-anticipated event will occur at a secret location on September 22nd with high security and only the closest, most fantastic friends and family included on the guest list. Even People magazine has gotten in on speculating on the couple's wedding attire. David Sherman, a humble start, a rocky middle, and from all accounts, what appears to be the beginning of a very promising future, thanks, no doubt, to the influence of a young woman who saved him from a potentially tragic demise.
'cause I always have to steal my kisses from you. I always have to steal my kisses from you. Always have to steal my kisses from you. I always have to steal my kisses from you. Now I love to feel that warm southern rain. Just to hear it fall is the sweetest sounding thing. And to see it fall on your simple country dress, like heaven to me, I must confess. 'Cause I always have to steal my kisses from you. I always have to steal my kisses from you. Always have to steal my kisses from you. I always have to steal my kisses from you. Kisses from you. I always have to steal my kisses from you. Always have to steal my kisses from you. I always have to steal my kisses from you. Always have to steal my kisses from you. I steal my kisses from you. Always have to steal my kisses from you.